Elon Musk reveals why SpaceX is ending the NASA partnership. Elon Musk's SpaceX and NASA have been in a partnership for quite some time now. They have even achieved so much together that NASA has assigned some of its top projects to SpaceX. But recently, he announced that the partnership between the two giants is coming to an end. What everyone is asking after hearing this is, why would he do this? Hello and welcome back to our channel. Today, we have a look at the reasons why Elon Musk decided to end the partnership between SpaceX and NASA. Remember to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more videos. With that said, let's find out why Elon did this. Revolutionary private space entrepreneur Elon Musk has actively spoken about his plans to build a Mars colony. He's been advocating for Mars exploration for a long time now. He even talked about plans to build a greenhouse on the red planet. However, the news came as a shock to everybody when Musk announced that the partnership between SpaceX and NASA was coming to an end. This was surprising, given that NASA accounts for roughly 43% to 48% of the total SpaceX revenue. There are two reasons why SpaceX chose to do this, but before we look at them, let us see where SpaceX stands at the moment. On April 17th, NASA announced the winner of its competition to design a spaceship that will return astronauts to the moon. Elon Musk's technique of leveraging economies of scale has achieved yet another milestone. There were three proposals in the competition. The first one was Dynetics, a regular supplier to the Department of Defense. The second one is Blue Origin, Jeff Bezos's aerospace company, which has already partnered with the usual suspects in the aerospace world, like Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, and Draper. The third proposal was from Elon Musk's SpaceX. Normally, NASA chooses more than one company for such arrangements. This is so that if one of them fails to deliver its technology on time, the other companies can act as a contingency plan. However, in this case, NASA awarded SpaceX the whole contract in its entirety. This is not the only time NASA has chosen SpaceX for its projects and contracts. In May 2020, NASA chose SpaceX to fly three of its astronauts to the International Space Station. This came as a surprise because NASA chose SpaceX over the mighty Boeing. NASA used another SpaceX rocket to deliver four more astronauts there in November 2021. This has made SpaceX become one of the most trusted partners of the government space agency. Why did NASA choose SpaceX? Elon Musk's firms are distinguished by their ability to leverage economies of scale. NASA's contracts are worth about $2.86 billion. These contracts assured SpaceX that it can develop, test, and send team missions to the lunar surface. The second flight is scheduled for 2024 and it will be manned. However, the contract's value could be multiplied by a very important factor. This is whether or not after this contract, NASA continues to place its trust in SpaceX, continues sending regular missions to the moon, or supplies a base there with a permanent facility. In many aspects, NASA's contract is a significant change from what it has proposed in the past. This is where SpaceX has the biggest advantage over all the other companies, and it was the most significant element in NASA's decision. Blue Origin's project seemed like the most controversial one. It had a three-stage landing design, which was in line with NASA's approach. However, no components were recovered virtually. Dynetics, on the other hand, delivered a more innovative and reusability-oriented proposal. However, they were ambitious, proposing that they take just a few astronauts onto the moon. In this way, getting the NASA contract is essential for SpaceX's plans to go to Mars. It also represents a change of scale for NASA, which had previously only aspired to launch one huge rocket a year, which would cost $2 billion. This rocket was then lost in the ocean. Now, NASA can start thinking about building one rocket a month and reusing it dozens of times. In addition, they can also think about carrying up to 100 tons worth of cargo. More launches mean more experience, leading to more economies of scale. The dimension of the space program could change completely if $2 billion allowed it to launch 100 tons of material into space every 2 weeks. Clearly, the rules governing various industries are not set in stone, and there is always room for a new and improved approach. However, even with all this, SpaceX is still breaking up with NASA, and there are two main reasons for this. The first one, the continuous and reoccurring lawsuits from Blue Origin. Space cowboy Jeff Bezos has been filing lawsuits against Elon Musk's SpaceX for quite some time. Elon has even criticized him for it. Earlier, in November 2021, Jeff Bezos' space firm Blue Origin sued NASA. This was after they lost a critical government contract to SpaceX to fly astronauts to the moon. This had a great effect on SpaceX's project since they had to pause its first. This adversely delayed their project. Now, Amazon has also approached the Federal Communications Commission, FCC, and urged them to dismiss the newly submitted plans by SpaceX to launch another cluster of satellites. SpaceX is planning to launch them to power Starlink, its satellite internet service. Elon Musk tweeted in reply to a story about the lawsuits and said, "Turns out Bezos retired to pursue a full-time job filing lawsuits against SpaceX." Amazon's request seems more like a protest than a formal lawsuit. However, it is not that they do not want SpaceX to launch more satellites at all. They just want SpaceX to be clearer on its plans to launch the satellites. Starlink currently has an estimated 1,740 low Earth orbit satellites powering it. These serve about 90,000 customers. SpaceX is planning to launch another constellation of about 30,000 second-generation satellites to improve the service. As a result, they must notify the FCC of their exact location around the globe. Amazon's main complaint is that SpaceX is asking the FCC to give the green light on two entirely different orbital configurations, which are to be chosen later. SpaceX's novel approach to applying for two mutually exclusive configurations is at odds with both the Commission's rule and public policy, and we urge the Commission to dismiss this amendment's rights. Maria Dodson-Schumann, corporate counsel for Amazon subsidiary Kuiper Systems, said. Schumann also said that having to grapple with two possible configurations doubles the technical effort faced by the operators, including Amazon's Kuiper system, which has yet to launch any satellites of its own. These parties will eventually have to review the interference and orbital debris concerns raised by the two satellite configurations. Schumann suggests that SpaceX should choose one plan and stick with it. She also claims that approving two configurations sets a bad example and that it will allow future satellite operators to hedge their bets while creating more work for the entire industry. She concludes that, accordingly, the Commission should enforce its rules, dismiss SpaceX's amendment, and invite SpaceX to refurbish its amendment after settling on a single configuration for its Gen 2 system. The other reason why SpaceX is breaking up with NASA is that SpaceX is planning to hold Starship's first orbital test flight in January. This test flight may lead to a little less focus on NASA's project. Elon Musk stated that his company plans to launch its futuristic bullet-shaped Starship into orbit in January. However, he is not guaranteeing success for this first test flight, as there are lots of risks associated with it. He commented during a virtual meeting held by the National Academy of Sciences and said, "So I would not say that it is likely to be successful, but it will make a lot of progress." Musk said that he is very confident. The Starship, which will launch on top of a mega booster, is expected to successfully reach orbit in 2022. After a couple of orbital test flights to be held next year, SpaceX would then start launching valuable satellites and other payloads to orbit on Starships in 2023. NASA has contracted SpaceX to use Starship to fly astronauts to the moon as early as 2025. Musk, however, plans to use the reusable ships to fly people to Mars. The shiny stainless steel Starship and its first stage booster, known as the Super Heavy, will be the biggest rocket to ever launch. Musk said that the 394-foot-tall rocket will have a liftoff thrust that will double that of NASA's Saturn V rockets, the rockets that carried astronauts to the moon about a half century ago. The Super Heavy has yet to be tested. However, in May, a full-scale Starship model flew to an altitude of more than 6 miles before successfully landing back at the space complex near Texas's southernmost tip. Musk says that the Starship and the Super Heavy to be used during the first test flight have already been completed. The company hopes to be finished with the launch pad and tower by the end of November and to begin testing in December. The Federal Aviation Administration should have a review by the end of the year. Afterward, there will be a launch in January or at the latest by February. According to Musk, SpaceX, with NASA covering the rest with its Lunar Lander contract, covered about 90% of Starship's development costs. Musk did not specify how much money had been spent thus far. He plans to build multiple Starships. To achieve his ultimate goal of making life multiplanetary, he imagines needing about 1,000 Starships. He claims that something natural or man-made will eventually bring an end to civilization. A pandemic worse than COVID-19, continually decreasing birth rates, nuclear Armageddon, or even a direct hit by a killer comet. He noted that moving people to Mars as fast as possible is important in preserving the light of consciousness. What do you think of SpaceX's decision to end the partnership with NASA? Do you think it is the right choice? Let us know in the comments section below. Remember to leave a like and subscribe to our channel for more videos. Also, hit the bell button to be notified of new videos. Thanks for watching. Until next time. Bye.